It was instrumental in settling Western Canada. The Canadian Pacific Railway was built almost 130 years ago, but it's the large contingent of Chinese workers that are remembered in the Kamloops Museum's latest exhibit, Chinese Legacies, Building the Canadian Pacific Railway.
Most of the railway workers had to work outside in all weather. Chinese Legacies is about the experiences of the Chinese laborers who came here during the 1880s to build the Canadian Pacific Railway, specifically the part that stretched from Yale, close to the coast, to Craigellachie in the interior. And that section of the CPR was probably one of the most difficult areas to build through, and it was very dangerous. And this exhibit talks about their experiences. They just generally lived outside and lived rough.
Experiences that often involved being overworked, underpaid, and asked to perform dangerous tasks to help build the railway.
They were paid probably about half as much, and they were engaged in all sorts of dangerous work to help build the railway, and through accidents and malnutrition and so on, disease, there was a high rate of deaths amongst the Chinese workers. So they weren't treated very well, but nonetheless they persevered, and they were a major part of getting the railway built. And I think modern British Columbia should look back on it and see this very real contribution that they made.
The exhibit features a number of artifacts that give a glimpse of what life was like for the Chinese workers in the 1880s during the CPR's construction.
One of them is a typical Chinese worker's hat. They're very mindful about working under the hot sun and staying out of the direct rays of the sun, so they would either buy a hat or make their own, or even bring some with them from China. There is a full-size mock-up of a laborer's tent. They lived in tents along the right-of-way of the railway, and as the railway progressed, they would pick up and move on and make a new camp and start work again from there.
But it's the land surveying before the railway's construction that is the focus of another photo exhibit, a collection of images, some of the first ever, of British Columbia's landscape.
And in the 1870s, the Dominion government decided to do a survey of British Columbia to prepare to identify a route for the railway. They thought we'd better send a photographer along. So they sent Baltsley, because Baltsley was very skilled in landscape photography, or view photography, which is what they called it then. It's very interesting because it shows the life of the survey party as they move from Victoria inland, including Kamloops, images of Kamloops, the wilderness they had to go through, and how hard it was to have a survey party go through British Columbia in 1871.
For more information on these exhibits and more at the Museum and Archives, visit city.kamloops.bc.ca/museum. For Shaw TV, I'm Sam Numsen.